this is not a press conference to announce a new scheme, but we just want to explain to you the new programming software which has been prepared by CBDT for e-verification, online verification of all the deposits which are made in the banks in the old currency during the period of demonetization. Well, काफी लोग ये कह रहे हैं, अलग-अलग लोग, कि demonetization के बाद CBDT के पास जो information आई है deposit के बारे में, उसके बाद लोग ये संदेह कर रहे हैं, एक fear कर रहे हैं, कि inspector उनके पीछे पड़ जाएंगे, लोगों को harass करेंगे, notices जाएगी, ये सब संभावना लोग प्रदर्शित कर रहे हैं। लेकिन आपको ये जान के खुशी होगी कि जो programming software CBDT ने इतने कम समय में बनाया है इनाउस, वो इतना बढ़िया है कि किसी के पास हमको जाने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। अब आप जानते हैं कि 99% पीपल आर फाइलिंग देयर रिटर्न ऑनलाइन, सबका अपना अपना एक एक ई फाइलिंग का अकाउंट होता है, तो उस ई फाइलिंग अकाउंट के माध्यम से ये डिपॉजिट हम उनको बताने जा रहे हैं, उसका हम क्वेश्चंस पूछने जा रहे हैं ऑनलाइन, so that there is no physical contact of any income tax inspector with the people. This is the purpose of explaining today's software. The name that CBDT has preferred to give it to this program is Operation Clean Money. And in Hindi, it is called Swachh Dhan Abhiyan. Swachh Dhan Abhiyan. It is just the name of the programming software which will be used to get answers on all the deposits which are made, and after getting all the preliminary answers from people, then only if the need be, we would be taking a legal action against those people. This is the purpose of this. I would like to compliment the team of CBDT, which has worked very hard to make this programming software a very good one, and that also in such a short time. Particularly the people from Directorate of System, Sanjeev Singh, and Director Systems and other people who have made it possible to have this. They've really worked very hard. My compliments to the team. Now I'll request Sushil Chandra to kindly explain the scheme, and then if need be through a presentation. We have a meeting at 3 o'clock with FM, so you just take 10 minutes.
Friends, as the Revenue Secretary has already told you that this is the scheme through which we will be verifying the deposits which have been made during the period from 9th November to 31st of December. We have got a large data. We got something around more than 1 crore accounts where the money has been deposited above rupees 2 lakh. They are having a unique PAN of around 70 lakh persons which are involved into these particular accounts. We have compared this vast data with the income profile, the turnover, and the various other particulars of income available in our income tax data bank. In the first phase, where the deposits in the account are not matching with our data, we are putting the same on our e-filing portal, seeking explanations about source of income. In the initial phase, we are putting data of those persons who have deposited rupees 5 lakh or more and deposits between rupees 3 lakh to 5 lakh of suspicious nature and who had poor tax compliance after 8th of November 2016. The money has lost its anonymity, as you are quite aware, after demonetization, and it has come in the banking channels. So it is easy for us to track the same. Therefore, through this particular scheme, we want to convey that it is necessary for the taxpayers to come clean and pay their due taxes on the deposits on which taxes have not been paid. For this, even the PMGKY is available till 31st of March only. This action initially covers only 18 lakh taxpayers whose data we have put on our portal of e-filing. No source of deposit is being asked from the small taxpayers who have got genuine tax compliant savings. It is also desired that the taxpayers, that their bank account should be complied and linked with the PAN Otherwise, in the accounts which we have got a balance of rupees 5 lakh and 2 lakh rupees was deposited during that specified period, the withdrawal will not be allowed by the RBI guidelines. So therefore, it is necessary that they should be duly linked with the PAN also. The time given for the response through this e-verification system is available for 10 days. And if there's any difficulty or any question, they can be available on the online. If the reply is not given within the stipulated time, only then the notice will be issued by the department. Otherwise, we want that everybody should give reply on the computer itself. There's no need to come to the office. And if their explanation is accepted, then the amount that particular thing will be closed. And they need not to visit income tax office at all. So the intention of this scheme is to avoid any harassment to the taxpayer. They need not to come to the office, and online verification will be completed. If any taxpayer feel any difficulty or harassment, the same can be intimated to the local chief commissioner or the CBDT, and our team will be ready to help any genuine grievance in this regard. I also want to communicate that this is a continuous exercise. That is a Swachh Dhan Abhiyan and Operation Clean Money is a continuous exercise to widen and deepen the tax base. All the accounts in which money has been deposited will be tracked, and we have hired the services of the data analytics as well. And ultimate beneficiary in the channeled accounts, in the layered accounts also, we will definitely identify. And this exercise will definitely widen and deepen the tax base. Now I would request Sanjeev Singh, my colleague, who will give a little presentation on this issue as to how this scheme will work.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. The verification of cash deposit, we have used data analytics, as sir has mentioned, to identify around 18 lakh taxpayers wherein the cash transactions do not match with the profile of the taxpayer. So that is a basic point, which means not every account has been identified for showing. Only accounts where the transactions are not in line with the taxpayer profile have been identified to be pushed for the e-filing portal. The online verification, the primary objective is lower compliance cost for the taxpayer and optimize the resources of the income tax department in conducting this verification. There's basically a three-step process. A taxpayer needs to log into the e-filing portal. It is inside the e-filing window of the taxpayer. And once a person clicks on the cash transactions 2016 link, the accounts and the amount of deposit will be viewed by the taxpayer itself. The details, this is just a sample screen where the name of the bank and the bank account and the balance or the deposit made in the bank account is being shown. The taxpayer is also required to give information about any other bank account which is not mentioned in this list. So that is also a link has been provided for that. To inform the taxpayers who may not be coming to the e-portal, tomorrow morning we'll be sending an email and SMS on the mobile number and email which is on the e-filing portal. Taxpayers who have not registered on e-filing portal till now would be few. We request them to register on e-filing portal. It takes less than 2 minutes to register on e-filing portal. Even taxpayers who are registered on e-filing portal should verify their email and mobile number and make sure that it is updated. This will make sure that any communication we send to them reaches them and they can come on the portal. Once the account is viewed, the taxpayer can confirm that the account belongs to them, because if that is the case, they'll be asked to give the explanation of cash deposit. In case account does not belong to the taxpayer or the client holder, they have a facility to give their response. And in such a case, we will pass on the information to the information source for re-verification. Once the account is confirmed by the taxpayer, the facility also allows the taxpayer to modify that deposit amount, because it could be in some cases the value being shown is not exactly the same which taxpayer knows which has been deposited. So the taxpayer has the ability to modify that amount and then give the broad way that cash has been deposited the source of that cash. So very simple, if you see, we have talked about how much cash is from earlier income or savings, or if cash is from any income or receipt which is exempt from tax, for example, agriculture income, that can be also mentioned. Along with that, there is a facility to also give remarks to explain the amount which is being stated there. Now, in case a taxpayer has got this money from other person or has withdrawn that amount from other bank accounts, facility has been given on the online portal to even capture these details. In case the list of such persons is large, a facility has been given for it to be captured in a CSV file or Excel file and upload on the portal. So a person can actually prepare the list and go back to the portal and upload. There is a, for simple taxpayer, it should not take more than 2 minutes to enter. If a taxpayer has got lots of explanation in terms of various persons who has given cash, we have given a user guide and a reference guide, which is one page quick reference guide, for them to understand the way it has to be filled up. Help desk number is given here, 1-800-4250-0025, to help the taxpayer in if they're facing any technical issues in submission of the response on e-filing. As Chairman CBDT has mentioned, the next stage would be some cases where the response is not in line with expected profile will be selected for verification. So not every case will be selected for verification. Only cases which match the risk criteria which will be selected for verification. In such a case, communication will be sent to the taxpayer electronically. And if any additional information is requested or required by the officer, that same will also be transmitted electronically. And this is just to add, as sir was mentioning, this is just the beginning of the exercise. The information on the portal will be dynamic. It will be updated when we receive new response by a taxpayer, when we get new information, or we do more analytics. So this is a continuous affair. We would keep on communicating with the taxpayer electronically and take it forward. Thank you.
Thank you. I think we can do it offline. There is a press note which our media coordinator will distribute, so you can just take it. I would really request you to reach up to the people and explain to them that this is the best way of reconciling the data without any harassment. So please, your media newspaper or media channel to propagate about this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. And friends, you are requested to join for refreshments on fourth floor.